As of October 20th of 2024, there are currently 49 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is 2 more than were erupting last week. One of these erupting volcanoes is Ethiopia's Erta Ale Volcano, a massive shield volcano located in the Afar Depression, which, interestingly, starts its edifice below sea level on land. Continuously erupting since 1967, Erta Ale has repeatedly filled one or both of its summit lava lakes, which occasionally overflow onto lower sections on or beyond its caldera rim in completely effusive eruptions. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In the Philippines, after months of escalating volcanic unrest at the Kanlaon volcano, including producing record sulfur dioxide emissions, the Kanlaon volcano finally began erupting. Heading 2,140 kilometers to the south, the alert level was raised at the Iya volcano, whose name correctly translates to the word yes due to the appearance and rapid escalation thereof in its rate of volcanic and harmonic tremor. But by far, the most concerning and top story of the week involves a very large and ongoing intrusion of magma within Ethiopia. This intrusion of magma is as much as 21 kilometers in length, with recent modeling suggesting its top is located at 4 kilometers or 2.5 miles depth. It seemingly formed on September 27, 2024, north-northeast of the Fantail volcano, and in the time since has caused the following things to happen. The appearance of a geyser and multiple hot springs where none existed beforehand, the appearance of large cracks in the ground, damage to a local railroad, and 7 magnitude 4 range earthquakes. Since a similar, albeit far smaller, volume intrusion which occurred in 2015 in the same spot had a composition consistent with rhyolite, I deem the current intrusion to also likely involve rhyolite magma, and am making a very rough guess that around 150 million cubic meters of magma is involved. This is not a good sign, as rhyolite in the East African Rift Zone always produces explosive eruptions, although to varying intensities, with my suggested volume of magma being capable of producing up to a destructive mid-NVEI-4 eruption. Due to all of this, already 700 people have been evacuated. But I think this figure should be expanded to around 10,000 people via a temporary 15-kilometer exclusion zone between any spot on the line between and including these two sets of coordinates. However, there is some good news. The rate of earthquakes and ground deformation has decreased by 75% day over day since the intrusion's first 10 days. Also, looking at similar intrusions in the north and eastern section of the East African Rift Zone since 1970, eruptions have only resulted on 5 out of 24 occasions, including 3 previous instances of this volcano where the intrusion failed to reach the surface in 1981, 1989, and 2015. This means that while potentially quite dangerous since an eruption is still technically possible, the most likely outcome by far for now is that no eruption ends up occurring due to this magma intrusion. Heading to the Philippines, after producing all-time record high sulfur dioxide emissions and 337 earthquakes on September 11th, emissions at the Kanlaon volcano had continued to progressively decrease. And then, without much warning, the volcano erupted anew on October 18th, sending a weak plume of ash 1,000 meters above its summit. These weak emissions continued, albeit infrequently, across at least the next 48 hours, although I want to strangely note that 5Volks does not think these count as eruptions. Instead, they simply state the ash emissions are due to increased degassing remobilizing prior ash deposits on the volcano. Regardless of which is the case, these weak ash emissions are likely to continue to occur during the next several days at a minimum. And in Indonesia, the alert level of the Iya volcano was increased from green to yellow on October 17th, resulting in a 2-kilometer exclusion zone in all directions around its summit crater. While heightened levels of earthquakes had been occurring since July 31st, something further changed on October 16th. There was an appearance and then sudden jump in volcanic tremor events, going from 9 to 19 to 29 tremors on subsequent days. On both the 17th and 18th, harmonic tremor was detected, absolutely indicating the movement of shallow magma. The following day, on October 19th, this harmonic tremor became constant for several hours, but the rate of volcanic earthquakes did not also similarly spike. This leads me to interpret that while, yes, magma is now in a section of Iya's magma conduit, the viscous mass is too wide to advance upwards quite yet. It will take some time for the magma conduit to expand from the bottom up before an eruption can occur, but if one does occur, it risks generating both pyroclastic flows and ejecting bombs of lava, the latter of which are responsible for fatalities during Iya's last eruption in 1969. So, depending on the intensity of an eruption were one to occur, parts of or all of the city of End, population 88,000, may need to be evacuated. And now, here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on October 20th of 2024. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron Paul Jeffrey for supporting this channel.